Good day, my dear friends. Wonderful to be with you again. It's a privilege to visit you at home. And I hope you're still safe and there's people looking after you. You're looking after yourself. But I've got one promise to you. One day, every single day when you wake up, it's one day closer to see your friends again. And even your teachers to go back to school. It is almost there. We are almost there. You just need to be patient. But before we start, I want to talk to you about honesty today, and let's sing these two songs, Awesome God and 10,000 Reasons, together.
Our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above. Our God is an awesome God. Our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above with wisdom, power, and love. Our God is an awesome God. Our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul.
soul, worship His holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul, I worship Your holy name. Bless You, time has come. Still my soul will sing Your praise unending. 10,000 years and then His holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul, I worship Your holy name. Come, bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul, worship His holy name. Worship Your holy name, Lord, I worship Your holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul, worship Your holy name. Jesus, I will worship Your holy name. Worship Your holy
name. Wow, it's so wonderful to praise and worship our God. Let's just close our eyes first and let's ask the Lord Jesus to help us with honesty. Father God, thank You. Thank You that You are a wonderful God. Thank You that You're an awesome God. Thank You that You give us wisdom, power, and strength, specifically in these times, Lord. Thank You for the strength and the power and the love that You give us. And thank You, Lord, that we can know and that we can sing to you, that we want to bless Your name, because there's 10,000 reasons why we need to bless You. But Lord, we also need to understand what honesty is. And please come and help us today to understand what it means to be honest. In Jesus' name, amen. Now, my friends, we're talking about kids with character. And kids with character shows love to others, even with honesty. If we're honest with each other, we actually love each other when we are honest. But what does the Bible say? Let's have a look at 2 Corinthians 8, verse 21. What does the Bible say about honesty? Providing honorable things. That's what we need to do. Not only in the sight of the Lord, but also in the sight of men. Now, my friend, honesty means that people can trust you if you're honest. Let's have a look at this video. Can people really trust you?
Honesty means always telling the truth. Can people trust you?
Be honest.
We always need to tell the truth.
Be honest.
Can people really trust you?
Be honest.
We always need to tell the truth.
Be honest.
Can people really trust you?
Like when you drop a nice vase and your mom doesn't see, do you tell her the truth or do you go, who, me? Just say that you dropped it and mother will say, thank you for telling the truth, I can trust you every day.
Be honest.
We always need to tell the truth.
Be honest.
Can people really trust you?
Be honest.
We always need to tell the truth.
Be honest.
Can people really trust you?
Like when you see a friend get bullied and the teacher comes near, do you just turn your back as if you didn't even hear? Just tell that nice teacher what you really saw then, and people will trust you if bullying happens again.
Be honest.
We always need to tell the truth.
Be honest.
Can people really trust you?
Be honest.
We always need to tell the truth.
Be honest.
Can people really trust you?
Like when you're doing your schoolwork and you want to cheat, do you look off your neighbor's paper or let them even take a peek? Just do your own work with integrity. Your teacher will respect your honesty.
Be honest.
We always need to tell the truth.
Be honest.
Can people really trust you?
Be honest.
We always need to tell the truth.
Be honest.
Can people really trust you?
Like when you butt in line and the teacher spies it, do you say, I'm sorry, or do you blatantly deny it? Just say that you cut and find the end of the line. Then people can trust you every time.
Be honest.
We always need to tell the truth.
Be honest.
Can people really trust you?
Be honest.
We always need to tell the truth.
Be honest.
Can people really trust you?
It is really about telling the truth. So, we must be honest. If you break something, tell your mom it was you. If you see someone being bullied, tell the truth to your teacher or your parents. And when it's exam times, do not peek at someone else's work. And I know it's difficult now that you can, if you peek at your smaller brother or sister's work, you're definitely going to fail because it's definitely not exactly what you've studied. And it also means that you do not lie and you do not steal or you do not cheat. Now, if you played cards before and you did cheat, that means that you are not honest, okay? So, always tell the truth. But why is it so important that we need to be honest? If you are honest, people will see it and they will start trusting you. They will have respect for you. And it's the right thing to do. And it feels really good when you do what is right. It also stops the wrong person from being punished. If you blame somebody else for something that you've done wrong, they are going to get punished. So it helps us, even if we make mistakes, to learn from our mistakes by being honest. But what happens when you are dishonest? People will no longer trust you, and they will not have respect for you. You will have to tell more and more lies to hide your dishonesty. And your punishment will get worse the more you lie and are dishonest. You don't want to be the person who is called a liar. Because when we are dishonest, people will point at you and you will feel ashamed. It's like this one picture where the small girl says, I don't trust monkeys. And then the monkey says to her, I don't trust humans. But what does an honest person look like? Honest person always tells the truth, no matter what the consequences. Sometimes we are honest and we tell the truth and we do get punished for the mistake that we made, which is not always very nice. But an honest person always admits when they are doing something wrong. You do not steal or cheat. You keep your promises and encourage your friends and your brothers and your sisters to always be honest. Now you and I have a choice. We must renew our minds. We always have a chance to decide to do the right thing. And every time we choose to do the right thing, our brains learns and it becomes easier to do what is right. But every time we decide to do the wrong thing, every time we choose to lie and steal or cheat, our brain also learns and it becomes more difficult to do the right thing. We have a choice. Even if other people do not see our dishonesty, remember, God sees it every time. We cannot hide it from Him. It's like the Bible story of Abram and Sarah, where when they were younger, Abram and Sarah moved to another country, and Sarah was a beautiful woman. And because Abram was afraid that the king of that new country, Abimelech, would kill him and take Sarah for himself as his wife, Abram lied to everyone and said that Sarah was his sister and not his wife. So Abimelech did not know the truth, and he wanted to marry Sarah. But God told him in a dream that Sarah actually were married to Abram. So Abimelech had to give Sarah back to Abram, and a lot of gifts also. And God actually protected Abimelech, even though he did not know the truth. Abram, on the other hand, had almost lost his wife because he lied. God would also have protected Abram if he spoke the truth. God would not let them kill Abram. So always be honest. Look at this tick. You must make sure that you can put one like this behind every single thing you think, do, or say. Now think a little bit. You buy a sweet at a tax shop, but the lady gives you too much change and you notice it immediately. What do? Do you keep it or do you give it back? You find 20 rand lying on the floor next to your teacher's table, or maybe at home you find a 20 rand lying on the ground. What do? Do you pick it up, look around, put it in your pocket, and decide, no, this is my take. I'm gonna grab this 20 rand. I'm happy chappy. I'm gonna do this. This is mine. Or are you going to think, renew your mind and say, my goodness, this is not my money. This would have been very great to have this 20 rand. Do you give it back to your teacher or your mother or father or who you think it belonged to? You promise your mother that you would tidy your room after doing your homework, but you would much rather watch TV. And you watch TV the whole day without cleaning your room after you told your mother that you will do that. If you've done that, you are dishonest. You are not doing an honest thing. Maybe you are in the shop and you see a friend taking something and putting it in his pocket. What do? Are you going up to your friend and say, my dear friend, that's not the right thing to do. You'd rather put it back. Or do you say, I caught you. I want a share of that. Don't do that. That is dishonesty. So here is your challenge. Tell yourself quickly and the people around you, I challenge you today. Do not lie, steal, or cheat. Always speak the truth. And remember, be honest. It is the right thing to do. People will trust you and they will respect you. Choose to rather be honest every single time. God sees it everything. Be able to put a tick mark behind every single thing that you think, do, or say. Go and do it. Don't just think it. Let's close our eyes and ask the Lord God to help us. And we pray to Him to help us with honesty. Father God, thank you very much that you will help me to be honest. Please Please help me to not lie, steal, or cheat. I really want to be honest, but sometimes it is very difficult to tell the truth. I know that you are the way, the truth, and the life. So help me with the power of your Holy Spirit, so that I can put a tick mark behind everything I think, do, or say. I want people to trust and to respect me, because I love them, as you expect me to do. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Let's sing this following song. Lord, I need you. This time we need you so much. Let's praise and worship you.
Lord, I come, I confess, bowing here, I find my rest, and without you, I fall apart. You're the one that guides my heart. Lord, I need you. Oh, I need you. Every hour I need you. My one defense, my righteousness. Oh, God, how I need. Grace is found, is where you are, and where you are, Lord, I am free. Holiness is Christ in me, is where you stand, I fall on you. Jesus, you're my hope and stay. And when I cannot stand, I fall on you. Jesus, you're my hope and
my friends, I had a wonderful time with you today. Thank you that I could talk to you about honesty. And yes, we need the Lord. We really need Him in these times, and especially also to be honest. So be blessed in the name of Jesus. Be safe and go and be honest.